Hello, hello. We're here in San Francisco for the No Against the Dakota Air Access Pipeline. We've got a crowd of about 300 to 500 people here this morning. Very militant. We're going to be marching down to 10th and Market. How you doing there, Dave? Good to see you, my friend.
Well, this is a beautiful market.
Hey, come over to Berkeley, Dave. We're doing a camp-in at Civic Center. So we got a nice crowd here today. I just got here. I didn't catch the beginning of the march. But we're marching along Market Street. And this is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan. There we go. So this will be a short march. We're only headed 2 blocks. As we're marching west on Market Street. Lost blocks of traffic. Anyway, you're live here in San Francisco with your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan, broadcasting No Dakota Access Pipeline protest. Why don't they stop? They should have stopped here for a minute or two. Block some traffic. Damn it. It's only a 2-block march. Yeah, I never think about disabled people on these freaking marches. You got all these ableist people at the front of the march running down the street. Fuck all the disabled people. Right? You run down the street, how are people going to see you? You're just a blur.
I paid for something with a 10, and it got changed back for a 5.
It's like either you have dog feet in red or something in trouble. Happiest best party ever.
Anyway, we're approaching Twitter HQ. So if you're out there watching, be sure to tweet out hashtag NODAPL. And we're live from San Francisco on Market Street. And I'm trying to keep up with the march. There should be some civil disobedience. We're headed to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, which issues permits on federal land for the construction of the no DAPL pipeline. So that's why we're headed, and that's why we're out here. Anyway, as soon as we get stopped, I'll check out the chat. Because most of you know that are watching, I'm pretty disabled, so I'm not going to be following this march all over town. Because, as you can see, they don't really give a fuck about me in the march. Go ahead.
No, we're not going to leave you. Get in there and I'll
push you. Yeah, well, I got a little more issues than that.
Okay. Well, right.
It's all good.
My job is to stay here with you, so
okay.
I'm going to do that.
All right, well, I'm just going to park it over on the side here. That's where
We just got to get out of this intersection.
Oh, well. Okay. They can wait a little bit.
That's right. That's right. But you're not going to go alone. That's all I'm saying.
Thanks. Okay? Appreciate it.
Yeah, all right. I get in trouble. Every person gets run over, it's like I get a ding.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know.
You made it.
We should have went slower.
Yeah, we should have gone on that more direct route.
Yeah, well. I'm a veteran. And I'm going to cut across and get on the sidewalk. So I get a better camera angle. All right, we're going to be getting a little closer in just a second. Chanting water is life. Watch out. These people that are out front are risking arrest, civil disobedience, for the, Dakota Area Access Pipeline. So, we're down here. We got a good crowd here today. Looks like about 500 people. Hey, how you doing? anyway, this is where the office, the San Francisco office of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers are. And we got a little bit of chaos going on here, which is always good. So you can see, there's people. We got a nice crowd here today. Let me get out of the way for you. All right. All right. All right. All right. Break it off. Break it off. How are you guys doing today? Got anything you want to say to the people that are watching?
Life.
There we go.
Stand with Standing Rock. Power of the people.
All right.
And don't give Donald Trump 1 minute. Fuck Trump and fuck Uber.
Don't even let him start.
There you go. So we're out here against the Dakota Access Pipeline. And for those of you who are watching, know that I've been to many, many protests against all kinds of pipelines. Most notably the No on Keystone XL, and spent quite a bit of time in D.C. working against that, and we were successful. Just like I think we're going to be successful in stopping this pipeline. So here, let me check out the chat for a moment, see who's talking. Oh, yeah, UK watching. Hey, thanks a lot. Always retweet. Yeah, you know, these marches, you know, we were only going two blocks, and you know they got to run down for the march. It's two fucking blocks. They should be blocking traffic, right? Stay on Market Street, you know, and yet, you know, it's ableist behavior. I've been calling people on that, like, all the time now, right? You know, you don't think about, you know, whatever. Let it go at this point. Right? But we are doing, we have a camp-in going, Occupy, at Berkeley City Hall, or Civic Center. We're organized for homeless rights, because the city of Berkeley does absolutely nothing. And we had 4 arrests last week, where they arrested a candidate for city council. And now we got him over the barrel. So we're going to be at the city council meeting tonight. We're on the agenda. So if you happen to be in Berkeley, drop on by. It's 1 block south of Bar, or east of Bar. So yeah, we got lots and lots of people out here. All right. Yeah, where's Red Z at anyway? I'm talking to them. So I get to talk to people that are watching. So, hey, how you doing? Good. A beautiful day here in San Francisco. Lots of energized people out here against the Dakota Access Pipeline. And thank you for watching, viewers. It's always appreciated. I should have known that guy. He had an earpiece just like the feds do. So this is where it's going to be at most of the day. We'll be up and running until the batteries run out or until 12 o'clock, whatever comes first. And no on the Dakota Access Pipeline.
No, what I wrote was build other power and solar power on their houses.
Right. That's Paul Kangas, for those of you that don't know who he is. A big proponent of solar power. Freiburg, Deutschland.
Amen.
There you go.
Freiburg, the green, the black forest.
Yeah, so if everybody was using solar power, then we wouldn't have all these stupid pipelines.
Amen.
So, there you go.
We could shut down the Apple campus.
I thought they were trying to shut that down. They still haven't gotten it yet.
In 10 years. The earthquake is coming this year.
Gotcha. Yeah, we got a nice crowd here, friends. Friends. Yeah, I got here just as the march started leaving.
That was one of the stated things in the meeting.
And just to let you know, there are people blocking the door. And I'll get up and get you folks some pictures of that in just a minute. I'm trying to catch my breath. Well, we got a militant crowd here today. Lots of signs. A lot of these signs were posted by David Solnit. He did a lot of the painting, especially some of the big ones on the end here. I'm going to walk around in just a second, show you a little bit more about what's going on. And if you're in the Bay Area and you don't have anything better to do, or if you care about the earth, we're going to be down here at 10th and Market Street in San Francisco. So do drop in. We could really use your support. That lady here is collecting money. Donations for the Sacred Stone Camp. So we're here. We've got the main thoroughfare in San Francisco, which is Market Street, completely shut down right now. So this is definitely going to be stalling the morning commute for a lot of people who have to take mass transportation. For people that are trying to get to work, we suggest you take the Muni Underground. More about what's going on. Lots of people. We've got crowds growing a little bit. We got about 600 people down here today. All right, we got a sacred dance. Opinion is split whether people should live stream that or not. So rather than have a bunch of people yell at me, I'm gonna stay back. See over here that we have a blockade of the door at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Yeah. You're welcome. Yeah, that's right in there, yeah. The only reason I know is because I've been here for protests in the past. So, yeah.
For another pipeline?
Yeah. Keystone, yeah.
Was it this big?
Yeah.
Same people? See the same faces?
Yeah.
Alright. Nice to get everyone back together again.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. Alright, just give me a second here, folks. Just for channel identification purposes, this is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan here, bringing you the No Dakota Access Pipeline protest here in San Francisco. So glad you joined us. So just a second here, folks. Let me get my jacket squared away. So for those of you just joining us, we're here in San Francisco for the No Dakota Access Pipeline protest. We've got a good crowd of between 500 and 600 people that are blocking Market Street. We have people that are blocking the entrances here to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, which they're the permit holders. They're the ones issuing the permits on public land. That was one issue that was brought up, was the pipeline. The original plans were slated to go through Bismarck, North Dakota, and when the residents of Bismarck found out about it, naturally they were up in arms. So these people that are out front are risking arrest by being out here. There's some more people, a little bit down. All in all, it looks like about 30 to 35 people are risking arrest here at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers in San Francisco. This is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan. So happy that you're watching. Yeah, folks, I quit paying attention to the news right after Donald Trump was elected. I'm kind of on a news boycott because of the Donald. You know, that tin pot fucking fascist. But I have been live streaming protests, anti-Trump protests, in addition to this one. And I'll try to bring you more as I'm on the scene. yeah, there's some of the, there's Dave Sullivan right there in the crowd. He's got the green scarf on. He painted a lot of these signs. He does a lot of artwork for protests. Thank you, Dave Sullivan.
Do we have Wi-Fi here? Shouldn't we have Wi-Fi here?
I'm not sure. I rarely find it that's dependable enough to even get mess with. So I just pay for it.
Starbucks.
Right over there in the Fox Plaza.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Let's go take a look at these people that are risking arrest. I find that direct action is kind of more important than the words. This is the entrance to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. These folks are risking arrest by being here to block the entrance. My only criticism, really, is that there's an entrance on the side of the building, and there's nobody over there blocking that entrance. So that's the only criticism. But thanks to all these great people. Yes! Right there, locked arm in arm. And I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 13 people in front of the door there. And then just a little further down, you can't see, but there's approximately 12 to 15 people that are also risking arrest. Oh, yes, this is one of a series of protests that are scheduled today. Cross-country. So if anybody knows other cities, could you please enter it in chat? And this is, I know that we're in solidarity with Standing Rock, but I'm sure that there's Chicago, New York, Washington, D.C. Those would be the likely places where there would be other protests. Let me check the chat. Yeah, no doubt. Well, I'm a firm proponent of direct action, so. Well, we're gonna go back to these folks. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't think, here in the United States, Americans are a strange lot when it comes to protesting. They're not as fierce as you guys are over in England or France or a number of other places. Simply because, most Americans are asleep. And, San Francisco is one of those places where there's more people awake, but they don't have enough experience at protesting. So. Anyway, the mood here is somewhat peaceful. I mean, you're not going to see people out here with bricks and bottles or anything like that. Which, now that we talk about the situation, maybe that's what we need. Yeah, a bunch of my friends went to Standing Rock. I thought about going for a second. So we got, right now we got lots of milling about.
We're all going to live together, we're all going to die together here. Well, I guess I'm done with family and time, because we got to create, here you go.
Tired, but all right.
Yeah, me too.
I was standing way over there, and I don't even know where the front of this was. It's so amazing and beautiful.
And it smells like sage out here. I'll let you know.
That we
Smells really good. Morning. You're not awake. Mainstream media out here, of course, and for many of you though that are watching, you know that we can't trust mainstream media to give us a story, so that's why we're out here. A lot of people are crowding in front of me. What you're seeing here is that we have people risking arrest. So I'm basically going to concentrate most of our live stream on this civil disobedience. So we really don't have an idea when we're going to start making arrests, but may or may be a few minutes from now or whenever. But I'll be here bringing you the arrests. This is Freeman Sullivan, your live streamer, here at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers in San Francisco, California. And we're covering the No Dakota Access Pipeline protest in solidarity with Standing Rock, North Dakota. And a big shout out to those folks up there who have had endured all kinds of abuse at the hands of the police and private security. So I've kind of staked out a spot here, and I'm not going to walk too far away because I want to be able to bring you the live stream of people getting arrested. So if you get bored, I know Rebsy, he's got his live stream up. Check his out. I don't know what city he's in. Could be St. Louis. That may be it. But at any rate. Yeah, Yeah, well, we're, I quit watching the news. You know, Donald Trump, he ain't my president. And Americans now, because of this election, are more divided now than they've ever been. And a lot of people on the radical side, my comrades, are we're actually looking at the possibility of civil war in this country. Because if Trump doesn't cool his rhetoric, that might be what's going to happen. Yeah, this is going to be my last live stream with this phone. I saw a nicer model, newer model. This phone has served me well over the last 3 years, but it's time to make an upgrade. And the picture quality will go up along with the new camera. I just saw Sergeant. You can see that we got a confab here. They're trying to figure out what they want to do. And you know, we still don't have a police chief here in San Francisco. So, you know, we got a rudderless police department. I'm sure many of you know about all the problems that we've been having here with our police department, which is, it's about par for the course with the police departments around the country here in the United States. Oakland doesn't have a police chief. Berkeley just recently promoted their police chief. So that's pretty indicative of most cities around the United States. There's a real problem with policing, a lot of violence, shoot to kill. There seems to be the watchword and not the escalation. And, you know, people are just sick of it here. That applause you hear is for people down here at the entrance that are risking arrest. We've got lots of people. Let me stand up here. And just to give you an idea how many people are here. And we're here, we're going to be waiting for the civil disobedience action. That's why we're staying put at this spot. And if you'll notice in the police officers' uniforms, they're all wearing their body cams now.
Because it is getting rid of the water and people getting larger.
hanging with these brave people that are risking arrest. I believe the charge they're going to get, if they do charge, it's, I don't think it's going to be trespassing. It'll probably be impeding public access or some bogus charge. My big question is, are they going to do jailhouse solidarity and not cooperate with the police? Or, Street has been blocked now for approximately a half an hour to 45 minutes by about a crowd of 500 to 600 people, and we're down here at the 10th and market at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers here in San Francisco. And this is your live streamer, Pre-Man Sullivan. Yeah, I'm kind of parked at this spot. We're going to give you coverage of the civil disobedience. People appear to have sat down. So. Protesters have sat down.
I mean, as you can see.
And we have a police line that's been formed across the front of the building by approximately 35 to 40 San Francisco police officers. But we're going to stick with the people here in front of the building. And for those of you that have been following my live streams, you know that I am a veteran of many pipeline protests around the country, most notably in Washington, D.C., where we camped out on the National Mall for a week with the Cowboy Indian Alliance out of Nebraska. And ultimately, we won victory in the Keystone XL pipeline, and I'm pretty much fully aware that we're going to be victorious in the struggle against this pipeline, too.
They were notified. Yeah.
Check out y'all that are logged onto the chat room. Okay. No new entries. Yeah, do me a favor, log onto the chat. Let me know how the audio and visual is here. If you can see and hear, I would really much appreciate it. And if you log on to chat, you send out a tweet, and that'll get us some more viewers. And I would appreciate that very much. We just had one protester that was told that he couldn't lean against the fence, and he went along peacefully. By all rights and everything, this is a peaceful protest. So.
Government, show us to deal with our people. As a nation, we because the United States cannot make any treaties with any entity, less than itself.
And just to remind you, for some of my international viewers, that we are on Native American land. This has always been Native American land, which is stolen from them, basically. The city of San Francisco sits on a Ohlone land, and when the first settlers showed up here, you can bet that killing Native Americans was a thing. So that's basically what this issue is about. More than any other, is the fact that the Energy Star, the company, I can't remember the name of the company, but it's based out of Houston, Texas, and they basically don't give a damn about Native people's rights here in this country. They're going to get that oil out of the ground no matter what anybody says. The pipeline was originally scheduled to go in the southern suburbs of Bismarck, North Dakota, which quite naturally is a white suburb. So they said, well, let's put it on Indian land. Nobody will care. Who cares about Indians, Native Americans? Who gives a shit? So the pipeline was diverted to go there. So that'll give you some of the idea of the institutional racism that goes on in this country today. Blow some of that in my direction, I don't mind. We got the smudge pots going. Ladies with their smudge pots, thank you. Which is the right, we're trying to purify this pot. I just noticed that some of the police officers have switched in their body cams. Helicopter overhead. So this is big news, folks. Market Street has been blocked now for close to an hour. These folks have been out here since around 8:30 this morning. The people. I don't know if you can see them.
But I know some Uber employees were entering on the side of 11th Street. But if you don't have to go to work, you should come join us in solidarity. It would be a good way to spend your time.
But for us, the sacred places are here on this land. And for us, the sacred places are connected. We stand on them. We're here. And the miracles that happen, happen now with our medicine people. And that's why you see. That's why you see a beautiful power is connected to the people, to the leader. Because this movement is spirit-driven. This is spirit-driven. Because before the pipe was blocked, our people were brought to Slipknot. And that was generations that had to purify in their lodges before something so holy and sacred as the pipe was blocked. And so those pipes have been committed all the way up to now, and they will be killing us. Yeah, so the ceremonies, the sciences, and the religious, and then those who have shared our people in a way so that we're able to stand up and make this fight. And the spirit is doing everything to the point where it is touched.
Somebody mentioned on the chat a little bit earlier, why aren't they chained together? This is basically a symbolic protest. It's not a hardcore blockade, so that's why people are not chained with pipes.
Now is what changes the world, and people have been like, what are we on? And we say, we're not a time of thanking you.
Also,
For those of you just joining us, we're here at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers here at 10th and Market Street in San Francisco. This is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan, and we should be here until 12 noon or whenever batteries run out. So we'll be here for the duration. If you're in the Bay Area, do come by. We could appreciate your support. And we're here against the North Dakota pipeline, Dakota Access Pipeline, originally called the Bakken Pipeline. That was the first name they had for it. So this is one of a series of protests that are going on across the country today in solidarity with Standing Rock, North Dakota. Oh yeah, you mentioned about Ghost Street. Hey, thanks a lot for the heads up on the audio visual. Very much appreciated. So I'm kind of parked out here. I'm not going to move around too much. I will stand up to show everybody. Maybe I can get a shot. There's more people.
Talking with somebody else, they were talking about the uranium mines being planned for the Grand Canyon. You know, and the thing is, they talk to Native people from across the world, across the country, on different ways that corporations and entities are trying to poison.
All right, they are opening the door here. I don't know what's going on.
And that's the meat face all over. Yeah. And it's a terrible thing to have to face.
But we got, it looks like a couple of these guys are Department of Homeland Security.
We don't need real money for our corporations. We need humanity for each other. So, we got a water song coming up, I believe. Alright, so.
Hello, relatives. My name is Andrea Becky, Chiricahua, Meshikaya. I want to sing a song that was taught to us over in Standing Rock. My youth recently returned. We plan on going back again. So they built a fire for an elder, and she sat down and she shared this song with us. Water is life, she said, and you need to sing to it and pray to it every day. A Japanese professor actually told her that when you talk to the water, the molecules move. When you pray, the molecules move. We are water. And the water knows who has done what to it. The earth and our mother know who has done what to it. It is time for us, the two-leggeds, to make that apology and to change what we have done to her. So the elder said every morning, you get up and you say, water, I love you. Water, I thank you. Water, I respect you every single day. So she taught us this song, and I'm going to go ahead and sing the song for you. And the song is, water, I love you. Water, I thank you. Water, I respect you. It is okay to be heard. I'm not the best speaker, singer in the world. But the elder said, share this song and take this song as your own. And share it in your communities. Teach your children every morning to get up and say this. And remember, without water, there is no life. So make sure you show your gratitude, your appreciation for that sacred element. Give me good.
looks like we're changing out some of the police officers out here. Give them a little break.
Officers inside, so that way we can get a little closer.
Yeah,
But at any rate, I continued on. I said, thank you for your service.
That's right.
You know, it's like the joke, I started Occupy Wall Street. Right?
Our fellow human beings and our non-human relatives.
You doing just got to
as soon as they start arresting these folks, everybody's going to start crowding the fence. So I'm going to sit here right by the fence so we can keep you, we can show you all the action.
Stay in the streets, keep fighting. We have a lot of work to do. It's lovely to be in solidarity with all of you. Bless up, whatever is life.
very much, Rob Clark. So we've got a special guest in the crowd. We've got Mike Freddy here, and he's offering to sing a song for us. So here we go. Thank you so much.
How you
feeling? First reason is that I believe in indigenous sovereignty. And I believe that indigenous sovereignty is environmentalism. And the second is that I believe in a renewable energy future for 100% of the planet's population. And that if we continue to invest in fossil fuels, we will have no chance to move into that renewable energy future, and it has to begin today. And the third reason that I'm here is to stand with you all and to stand with millions of people around the world. I just finished a tour of Australia and working with indigenous people in Australia who are going through the exact same battle there. I just returned from a tour of Europe where thousands of refugees from Syria are being displaced from the camps where they're staying. And this battle is worldwide and it's taking place. And we are here today to stand with millions of people around the planet who are saying that we need the human and the natural interests of the planet to take precedence over the corporate and materialistic interests of this planet. To the east, to the west, to the north and south, to the east, to the west, one love people never gonna stop now. To the east, to the west, to the north and south, to the east, to the west, one love people never gonna stop. One's a creation, one's the soul, one's the morning, one's the one. One to the air and the freshness we breathe in. One to the force of the change in the seasons. One to the mother from which all things come. One to the daughters, one to the sons. One to the father who helps us believe that nothing's ever gonna harm you, see. And one to the soldier who walks these streets. And one to the soldier who fights overseas. And one to the man who gets down on his knees and prays for guidance and protection, please. To the east, to the west, let me in. To the north and south. To the east, to the west. One love, people never gonna stop now. To the east, to the west. To the north and south. To the east, to the west. One love, people never gonna stop. One to the woman, one to the man. One to the culture from the time that it began. One to destruction, one to birth. One to the people who still fight for the earth. One to the people who suffer for the needs. One to the people who get down on the knees. One to the people who fight for the trees. One to the Lorax who speaks for the trees. And no amount of money, no amount of man can bring back to life what's gone when it's done. I said no amount of money, no amount of man can bring back to life what's gone when it's done. I said no amount of money, no amount of man can bring back to life. It's gone when it's done.
Yep.
Run to the people.
Yes, it is. No ins or outs, sir.
What are you happy? You got a day off.
Sleep when it's gone.
You really want to work, I guess.
Yeah. To the east, to the west, to the north and south. To the east, to the west, one love people never gonna stop now. To the east, to the west, to the north and south, to the east, to the west, one love people never gonna stop. You see, life is too short to make just one decision. Music's too large for just one station. Love is too big for just one nation. And God is too big for just one religion. One to the Baptist is healing and flowing. One to the tears of the things we let go. One to the man who gets down on his knees and prays for guidance and protection. Peace. To the east, to the west, let me hear. To the north and south. To the east, to the west, one love people never gonna stop now. To the east, to the west, to the north and south. To the east, to the west,
gonna let people never gonna stop.
Approximately 150 people that are risking arrest here at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers at 10th and Market here in San Francisco. And we're here to get the so-called money shot.
I bring solidarity from all of us now, legal services for prisoners with children and formerly incarcerated convicted peoples and families, and those representing 70 million people in this country. Many of us, most of us, people have been in cage. And this is one
the
of
whole the, building.
But I need to remind people that Leonard Peltier, if you know who he is, and if you don't, use any of the devices you have in finding out. He's a native person who stood up over 40 years ago for the rights of native people. So I'm here to ask you to do something. So, Obama's getting ready to leave office. Leonard's been locked up for a long time. If you could just put pen to paper and write Obama and tell him his legacy might be best measured in what he did for somebody who stood up for all of us, say it's our water, that they stood up for us. And Leonard is not the only political prisoner, and that's what he is. So you can go to a website called Jericho and find out who's locked up for doing what you're doing. This is really a privilege that we're able to stand here and not find ourselves in cages. So we need to keep that in mind. The other thing we need to know is we have some other privileges, and that privilege is resources. And we're able to be out here meeting there's some resources here. The people who put this on are honorable people, and I think we should be able to trust them to give them resources to go to Standing Rock so that people can stand and not starve while they're standing or freeze while they're standing. So if they are indeed protecting our water, our rights, I think they've been doing that from the very beginning of the colonization process. So let's get with the program and start standing with them fundamentally and not as a concept. So write Obama, tell him to cut Leonard loose and all the other federal political prisoners.
So yes, you got it for the lady who's in charge of the security for the building, and she said the building is on lockdown. So the protesters here have successfully shut the building down. There will be no pipeline business going on at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers today. So there you had it for the lady in charge of security.
People's side. Barack Obama, you can't hide. who are holding it down. And they asked us, when you go back to San Francisco, when you go back
to I think I would have to put on my my jacket. It's starting to rain out here.
Help us get the truth out.
So give me just a second.
The lies and the distortions. There are so many. But I want to address one. When I was in Bismarck, the atmosphere there was everywhere that said, drill, baby, drill. We're oil country. Drill, baby, drill. And this was really startling to me in terms of it was just so perverse there. And so what we wanted people to know is this drill, baby, drill came out of an illusion that is jobs versus environment. Is it jobs versus environment? It's a big lie. That pipeline, Dan Greenjo, that pipeline, the utility of that pipeline is going to be only 8 years. The utility of that pipeline is only going to provide 40 permanent jobs. Is that jobs versus environment? 40 permanent jobs. But I also want to say that the building of that pipeline is providing part-time temporary jobs to the construction people. This is 1,000 construction people who reside in places called man camps. Can you say that? Man camps. The women asked us to come back and share the stories about the construction of this pipeline and the violence it is inflicting on the women and the youth. The building of the pipeline not only will bring toxins, not only will cause a leak and an explosion, but the building of the light pipeline is violent and is not sustainable. These man camps are responsible for the trafficking of women, our young women. These man camps that are inherent in the construction of pipelines and with fracking is responsible of the bringing of drugs into the community. And it is also responsible for the disappearance of our young. The women at Standing Rock asked us to please tell you that it is these jobs that are not sustainable, but they are also violent, and the women are bearing the brunt of this violence. And we say no to the man camps, no to DAPL. The final thing I want to say is that up at Standing Rock, the women and the youth are leading the way for us to transition from a fossil extracting economy. They are up there with the men building a place where they are not going to rely on fossil fuels.
Thank you.
There is one thing that is constant in Nebraska, North Dakota, and that is sun, and that is wind. And we can transfer our economy to a just transition
building is on lockdown. No one is supposed to get entry.
So usually what they do is they go to one of the and say,
so first we need a round of applause for the folks who are hosting today. This has been a beautiful morning. How many of you
for being here. So, I have a policy.
For those of you just joining us, we're here at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers at Market and 10th in San Francisco. We're here protesting the Dakota Access Pipeline. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is responsible for issuing permits on federal government land. That's why we're here. The building has been shut down. They're closed for the day. So, protesters did their job. And now we're here waiting for them to risk or be arrested in an act of civil disobedience.
So I would like to ask you now.
And thank you for watching.
To take all of the Andrew Jacksons that you have in
Boo.
Your wallet or in your pocket. And some folks are coming around with buckets. And I'm going to ask you to put those in there. Both as a statement of resistance to Andrew Jackson and what he stood for, but also in gratitude for the rain that's falling. So, you know, none of the other ones were that great either. So Lincoln oversaw the largest
public execution
in the history of the United States. When he ordered the execution of the Dakota 38. So if you have Lincoln in your wallet, in the bucket. George Washington, in the bucket. That's right. George Washington was part of the crew that started this mess. So we want to get him out of our wallets. Who's on the 10? Who's on the 10? Whoever it is, in the bucket. We really want to support this. This event today was put together by I Don't Know More and a lot of our allies. And so let's give it up for everybody who worked on this day. And we all did it as volunteers, and we donated money to put the signs together. David Solnit is our master artist who's kind of facilitated all this. So there's been an art crew, and a medical crew, and a monitor crew. Let's give it up for Paul and the monitors, Paul Inara. A lot of people put a lot of time, and we all donated it, so that the money that goes into the buckets is going where? Where? Where?
Standing Rock!
That's right. All of it is going to Standing Rock. So please, please be as generous as you can. And if you're writing a check, okay, who do we make a check out to? Let's make it out to the tribe. Standing Rock Sioux Tribe. And we'll send it to them. Okay. Okay, where are the buckets? What are we doing? Okay, great. We have somebody who's going to lead chants for us while the buckets go around.
So, if you're looking for the buckets, please contribute to the camps that are out there at Standing Rock. That's why we're here today. They are the ones putting their bodies on the front line, and they are the ones there in 24/7 prayer for us here. So please contribute. The buckets are going around, and look for people with yellow or orange vests. Look for people with yellow or orange vests for those buckets. And then we're going to have some chance as the buckets go around. Thank you.
I'm Reverend Ted Galeano, all the way from the Philippines, just to tell you.
they used to, but one of the ones that they do when they go on action is up there, when we were shutting down work sites up Standing Rock, we'd say, Black Snake, and the response is, Killer, Black Snake, huh? Black Snake? You gotta kill that snake so it doesn't kill our kids. That's the fact of the matter. Alright, so I guess, song time? Or no? Yeah, song time? Alright. Sorry, I kinda got the mic handed to me and wasn't quite ready for it. You know what? I'll pass it up to Will. It's time for prayer and I'll do the song afterwards. So, you're sorry. I forgot your name. Greetings, people. Power to the people. We are the people. This is an international movement. It's not a small movement. This is about the water for all human beings. It's not an indigenous movement. It's a people's movement. It's an international movement.
So far, no movement by the police.
In Standing Rock that I've known for 38 years. And many of us...
The protest was scheduled to end at 12 noon. So there should be some arrests between now and then.
I'm glad I'm alive. And I'm glad to see this.
And again, we're out here. The hashtag is... Hashtag no DAPL. Dakota Access
Pipeline. Now, women, all women are very strong. My mother was a strong woman. My grandmother ruled our family. So,
ain't no problem, UK.
About to me. Water is life. Great Spirit, thank you for allowing us to be in your world. This is your world. You created us. We are just here for a short time. We need to mobilize millions and millions of more people to keep the pipelines away. We don't need the oil. The oil needs to stay in the ground. It's natural. We're not supposed to be using oil. That's not natural. Creator, watch over all these people. We belong to the human race. We all need to drink water. Thank you, my sisters and brothers.
And that big cop to the left of your screen, he's in charge of what's going on here.
Listen, I know we're talking about power to the people.
Can't see him
now. I know
I'm
new to this movement, and
the guy moving here.
Bear with me. I really have to.
The guy at the center of the screen. He's the in charge of this detail.
Please give me an opportunity. I'll do it as quickly as possible. First, allow me to introduce myself. I'm being motivated by spirit here.
Okay,
so
folks, my battery just signaled to me that we're going to go down for about a minute. Let me replace the battery, and I'll be right back.
Today I have a lot to say, and I hope you will bear with me to the end. Some of what I have to say may frighten you, but this is not my intention. I seek only to speak the truth of what I know, mostly because what I have to say.
All right, we're going
to
go down for a second, folks.